Hey guys, welcome to my channel. So if you have seen my other video, you will know what this video is about to be about. Okay, so I thought I'd come in here and just a tiny bit for you guys, because you know I'm producing two videos in a month. I think that deserves a round of applause, please. Thank you. Because how? Okay, let's move on. So in this video, what I'll be doing is upcycling this gorgeous bag here. And this is a bag I got from Mind charity shop, and I got that for £7.50. It's just a normal straw bag. I think it originally was from Next, but it's seen better days. Okay, it's not the worst, but it's seen better days. So if you've seen some of my stories and stuff, the inspiration for what I'm about to do, I'll put a few pictures here. And also the technique I am gonna follow without much guidance is on this side, so I'm gonna kind of look at that and also semi wing it as well. You know, that's what we do. When you're creative, you'll figure it out somehow. Okay, so before I actually filmed myself trying to figure out how to do this one, it took a minute, so I thought I would now use the knowledge I have just, you know, gained from doing this, and now I can actually show you how to do it a bit better, not like professionally, but a bit better. Okay, so I knew I wanted my tassels to be quite long and a bit extra. Okay, so to make them long, you're gonna need to kind of find something that's the height that you want them to be, the length you want them to be, because what we're gonna do is take our string and we're gonna wrap it around. For me, I wrapped mine around 9 times. Okay, I started at the top, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, finished at the top, and then what you do is tie the middle, take it off. It should be like in a long loopy mess. You take it off, you tie the middle, then we're gonna, you know what, it's better if I show you. It's knocking myself out. It's better if I show you. But what you're going to need for this video is some, I don't know what to call this, it's not really yarn. You can use yarn if you have yarn, but this is like a very stiff string, which is nice. I do have a, like a dream catcher here. I didn't make this. I got this from a store, and I really was loving the way these tassels were looking and how long they were. Really cute. So I kind of used that as well for inspiration. And the string is kind of the same. This one's just a little bit softer. So if you wanted like wool, then go for that. But I think like mine's just a bit more like a yarn string. Very, very stiff. I'm using a tape measure as well to measure out the length of the yarn I'm going to need. Some pins to hold it in place. Some E600 glue. You're going to need some scissors, fabric scissors, or just normal scissors is good enough. I've actually got my tweezer here, and I've got my snips just in case. Okay, I'm going to show you how to do that technique once, and then we're going to speed through the rest of this. Okay, so sit tight, let's go. This should be a fun video, guys. Okay, so the first step is to cut yourself 2 pieces of string that are 6 inches long each. All right, then you get the object that you're going to use to measure out your tassels, and you can do as I did, and you can measure it out 9 times. I've wrapped it around the object 9 times, but you can do it much more if you prefer. But I just didn't need the full look. I just needed a little bit of drama for my look, so I did it 9 times around the object. Okay, well, so once that's done, just snip the end off and slide off the thread off the object. Now you should have a continuous loop with 2 open ends. Okay, so what you're going to do is find the middle point between the long string you've just wound. Before you do the tight securing knot in the middle, just make sure your tasseled ends or your looped ends are all even. So once you do that, double knot the middle, okay, and leave the ends of the string free. So you'll be using that to tie it onto the bag later. Okay, so now what you're gonna do are cut open the looped ends and just even out the strings as you're doing that. Just make sure they're all the same length. Once that has been done, what you can see me doing here now is just adjusting the thread to the middle, and I'm almost molding the thread to a downward hang, okay? So I want it to hang nicely, so I'm just molding the thread around, and then I get my second string and I tie it very tight around the top, so you're almost creating like a head for the top of the tassel. I tie it once in the front and twice at the back. Okay, because of the first tassel I did, I was able to see that the ends of the thread were just sticking out, and I didn't like that. So what I'm doing now is securing the threads down in place with some pins. And just so they don't move, where you can see the edge getting a bit frayed, I just kind of put some E600 glue on there and kind of molded it into the rest of the string so that it's not like a frayed sticking out edge. Everything will just lie flat and it wouldn't come undone at any point because the glue is quite strong. Okay, so I've done that to all of the tassels from here on. All right, so after that, I'm just gonna kind of figure out where I want this tassel placed on the bag. I do it by eye first just to see the hang of it, and then what I'll do is then measure it out properly to see how many inches I need between each tassel. So I'm going to go with 4.5 between each of my tassels, and I'm just going to kind of stick the tweezer in to mark that spot and hold it there. And then what I do is use the tweezer to grab the edge of the string. Sorry that it's a little bit off camera and you can't see it. I think I should be showing you a little bit later as well. So I should be just pulling the string through with my tweezer. It was a little bit fiddly, but in the end, we got there. And success. Can you see? It's pulled through. So once you've pulled it through the weft, I want to say the weft of the straw bag, I don't know what it's called, but once you've pulled it through, just double knot it and make sure it's tight enough and secure. And then what you're going to do after that is just use your tweezer to kind of just push the edges into the bag. Okay, I hope you can see what I'm doing here. Push the frayed edges into the bag, and then just kind of, that'll be it really, that'll be it for your tassel. And then what you're going to do is repeat this step as many times as you need for as many tassels as you want, and then you should have an amazing bag. But you can watch me do the process as well, so just enjoy that. I was showing you the glue just now as well because that could be an option for you to secure it again with some more E600 glue. As mentioned before, you just do this step as many times as you need for as many tassels as you need. So you loop it around the object, you tie it off, you cut the loops open, you fold it down, you wrap some more string, the smaller string, around the head of the tassel. And then what I'm doing is sealing off the frayed edges with some glue as well. Then I'm leaving them to dry on the side. Okay, so yeah, I'm just gonna keep doing it over and over. I think I do this about 8 times because I want 8 tassels on my bag, and I've spaced them 4.5 inches between each tassel. Then I've just attached it evenly to the outside of the bag. Yeah, there's not much more I can say on this step. You can just enjoy me doing it, and it's quite fun to do. It's very different to do. And I recommend that you try something new because I surprised myself with this one. It wasn't a very hard project to work on, but it was a fun one. And now I've got a really cute bag that I can say it's thrifted and it's DIY'd. Yes! So I'm so happy that I've actually stuck to what I wanted to do and I've actually got it done. And now I've got a really cute bag for the summer. So finally I'm attaching them all. I decided to make them all up and then attach them all at once so that I'll get more like a complete look instead of like a one-off, one by one kind of look. And here I am doing the smaller thing I mentioned to you, where I've done a small one and I've attached it to the front loop of the handle. And yeah, it just looks like a cute little key ring that I've attached to the front of the bag. I think it just completes the whole look, and I'm so happy that I tried this. So I'm just gonna show you guys how it turned out, because I'm super excited that it actually came out exactly how I wanted it. Hey guys, so we have reached the end of the video. If you were doing it along with me, then that is amazing. If not, thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed it. But the moment that we've all been waiting for, guys, it's just cute. I like it, and it will do exactly what I need it to do this summer, which is do it too much. All right, this is the tassel bag. That's the bag, guys. What a way to upcycle. This is looking delicious. What a way to upcycle. This is giving me bohemian summer girl vibes. Look at this. Imagine this with a maxi dress. Imagine. Oh, you know what? Thanks for watching. Let's cut to the scene where you see it with the original look that it was meant to be worn with, and also I'm going to show you it with a maxi dress, because girl, we about to show out this summer. So thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed it. If you want to see more videos like this, please leave a like and a comment down below, guys. Also subscribe to the channel, guys. I love you so much, and I'll love you even more if you subscribe. So guys, I hope you also try to do something that is along the lines of DIY or upcycling this year, because this year is all about sustainability, looking at the stuff we have in our wardrobes and just creating something new and something creative and something that is unique to you. So I'm gonna go wrap my bag and I'll see y'all later, okay? Bye.